आ रहा है ये पूरा। हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज विनीत वर्मा फ्रॉम सेवन स्टार ग्लोबल स्कूल नैनी। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10th। द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज इलेक्ट्रिसिटी। द टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस। Electric charges. So first of all, we will discuss the structure of the atom. We know that every object in this world is made up of tiny particles called atoms. Atom, structure of atom is this, which is made up of proton, neutron and electrons. Electrons are revolving in their respective orbits, but proton and neutrons are situated in the nucleus of the atom. You already studied in your previous classes that the nucleus of the atom is positively charged and the electrons are negatively charged. So nucleus is positively charged and electrons are negatively charged, which are revolving around the nucleus of the atom. So you can say that every body in this world, every object in this world is made up of protons, neutrons and electrons. Actually you can say wholly as a whole, it is a neutral atom, is a neutral atom. Why it is a neutral? Because the number of protons and the number of electrons are equal in number. So they will cancel out to each other their respective charges. This is the reason it is wholly taken as a neutral. Now come to the second point of this atom. I have already discussed atom. In atom there are two charges, protons and electrons. Neutron is also there, but it has no charge. So I am not discussing about the neutron. Protons is positively charged and electron is negatively charged. Now come to the third point. Now I am discussing, take a glass rod and another silk cloth. Now rubbed the glass rod with a silk. This is before rubbing. Take glass rod and silk. Before rubbing, this glass rod is neutral and this silk cloth is also neutral. Why it is neutral? Because the number of electrons and protons are equal on the glass rod as well as on the silk cloth. Now this is the condition before rubbing. Now this glass rod should be rubbed with silk cloth. What happens? The sum of the electrons from the glass rod will be transferred to this silk cloth. When some of the electrons are transferring from glass rod to the silk cloth, after losing the electrons, the glass rod will become positively charged, because there is a deficiency of electrons on the glass rod now. So this glass rod will become positively charged. Now, because at the same moment the silk cloth is gaining the electrons from the glass rod, so it will become negatively charged. The charge will be conserved as a whole. Charge will not be lost. Charge is transferring from glass rod to the silk. The first one will become positively charged, and which is the accepting the electron from the glass rod, which is silk cloth, will become negatively charged. Okay? So a body gets positively charged if it is loses the electrons and becomes negatively charged when it gains the electrons. So it should be clear to all of you. Now, I am going to teach you property of electric charges. Property of electric charges, I have already discussed, there are two types of charges, positive charge and negative charge. Number one is opposite charges or unlike charges attract each other. Means opposite charge or unlike charges means you can say positive charge and negative charge. So I have taken the example of the first one charge is Q1, which is taken as positive, mentioned with plus charge, plus sign, and the second one is Q2 charge, which is taken as minus, you can say negative. These dotted lines are expressing the force of attraction. Both of these charges are attracting each other by the same amount of force. This is called force of attraction. Why they are attracting each other? Because they are opposite in nature. The first one is positive charge and the second one is negative charge. This is the reason they are attracting to each other. So it should be clear that the opposite charges attracts each other with the same amount. Now, second one, similar charges or like charges repel each other. Similar charges means, suppose that this is positive, Q1 is positive and Q2 is positive. Both are the positive, or you can say, you can take this is negative, this is negative. These are called similar charges. In this case, positive charges are similar in nature, so they will repel each other. This Q2 charge will exert a force on Q1 in this direction, and this charge Q1 exerts the force on Q2 in this direction. So we can write it as force on, F means force. Force on charge Q1 due to charge Q2 is represented by this arrowhead, and this is the line F21, means force on charge Q2 by charge Q1. Both the charges are repelling to each other by the same amount. F12 will be exactly equal to the F21, but opposite in direction. So we can write it as F12 is equal to minus F21. Why negative sign I put there? Because both are acting in the opposite direction, but the line of action will be same. Okay, now SI unit of electric charge. SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. Why it is called coulomb? Because Mr. Coulomb, scientist Coulomb, was invented. So this is the reason it is called coulomb, and it is represented by the symbol C, capital C. Okay, now I will explain one coulomb. What is one coulomb? One coulomb is that quantity of electric charge which exerts a force of 9 into 10 to the power 9 newtons on an equal charge placed at a distance of 1 meter from it. Means when the two charges are placed at a distance of 1 meter, then charge 1 coulomb will exert equal forces on both of the charges by the amount 9 into 10 to the power 9 newtons. Important about the charges, I have written particle and the charge. The particle, proton, electron and neutron, and their respective charges are shown here. The proton is positively charged with 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and electrons minus 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, and neutron having no charge. So proton contain this charge, electron with negative sign, and neutron will be neutral, no charge. So this is the first topic I teach you. The second one will be upload it very soon. Thank you very much.